Hello everyone, this is Dina from VxRail GSC support team. In this video, we are going to cover the workaround instructions for the USB controller bugs CVE-040 and CVE-041, and also the recommendations to mitigate the issue. First, let's have a brief description about these vulnerabilities, also called the USB controller bugs. VMware has published recently VMS-A0004 that addresses security vulnerabilities found and resolved in the VMware ESXi, VMware Workstation, Fusion, and VMware Cloud Foundation products. Briefly, patching the VMware ESXi, Workstation, and Fusion are the fastest methods to resolve these issues. There is also a workaround to remove the USB controllers from the virtual machines, which we are going to discuss in this video. These bugs, specifically CVE-040 and 041, are found in the USB controllers for the VMware ESXi, Fusion, and Workstation. Exploitation could give attackers access to workloads inside the organization's virtual environments. Taking advantage of this USB bug, anyone with local administrative privileges on a virtual machine would be able to execute code as the VM's virtual machine extension, the VMX process, running on the host. The VMX process mainly runs in the VM kernel, and it is also responsible for handling input-output to devices that are not critical to performance. And it's also responsible for communicating with user interfaces, snapshot managers, and remote console. Moving forward to the workaround to address this issue, the workaround is for both CVEs. To remove the USB controllers from the virtual machine, and as a result, USB pass-through functionality will be unavailable. Taking into consideration, while the ESXi host supports hot removal of the USB controller, the guest operating system of the virtual machine must also support the hot removal functionality. If the guest operating system does not support hot removal of a USB controller, then the VM will need to be powered off. To make sure that the guest operating system of the virtual machine supports the hot removal functionality, you can refer to the vendor's documentation. Okay, so let's start applying this workaround on our environment. First, we are going to log into the vSphere client UI, then navigate to the data center, click on VMs tab, and then on the virtual machines, which we are already on. Then we are going to navigate to the virtual machine on which you want to remove the USB from. Right click on the virtual machine, then edit settings. Also ensure that the USB controller is not in use prior to removing it from the virtual machine. And if required, power off the virtual machine. In this case, there is no requirement to power off the guest OS. Okay, so we are going to navigate to the USB part and then remove the USB controller. Then click on OK to apply the new virtual machine configuration. Okay, you will find that the status of the task has completed. That's all for this workaround. That's all for today. Thanks for watching and have a great day.